I met Brian in Brooklyn. He had just been discharged from the Air Force, and so his family was giving him a party. Brian always wanted to be a police officer and work for the bomb squad. I could tell he was attracted to me, and it was mutual. And he said, "I can't stay tonight, but someday I'm going to marry you."
My dad was a very charismatic guy. Really tall guy, really strong guy. He loved to sing. When I was, I want to say 14 or 15, I started playing guitar. I found a notebook that of songs that he had written. Just being around him was just fun. I'm very proud he dedicated his life to keeping people safe. I wanted to be a police officer for the longest time. I mean, who doesn't as a kid? Now he was literally my hero.
I met John on November 27th, 2001. It was his birthday. We were always friends, but one night we were both out and I knew from that moment that, you know, this was gonna be something special. John's dad was a firefighter, and I think he always knew he wanted to be a firefighter. He loved being a firefighter. It was a part of him.
Well, first responders know when they take the oath of office that they're putting their lives on the line to protect life and property in our city. And that being said, they also have families to take care of. Those two factors don't always agree with one another. Knowing that there is an organization that will take care of their family should the worst happen is very comforting, and it's very necessary.
On September 11th, 1976, I was waiting for Brian to come home. The news was on, and I heard Walter Cronkite talking about a bomb. I saw him on the TV, he and his partner carrying the bomb out of Grand Central. That was the last time I ever saw him. There was a knock on the door, and I knew. I could hardly walk down the stairs. We have two sons. They were 2 and 4 when he was killed. And I simply said, "Daddy has gone to heaven." And I remember my oldest son saying, "How did he get there? And can we go see him?" That was the hardest part, that he was a great man that his sons never got to know.
September 11th, 2001, he was stationed there. He was one of a few officers that was stationed at World Trade Center Command. So I was 9 years old. I remember being in a reading class. The janitor of all people came. He had said that a plane had struck one of the buildings. And once I found out, I knew he was there. I knew his work schedule. I've heard accounts that he went back in multiple times against orders. On the last time he went back in and didn't make it back out. We're just looking on TV to see how, hey, maybe, does that look like him? Does that look like him? Every time the phone would ring, we would all just jump up. And my mom got a phone call from a detective. That's when she found out. She was holding a glass of water. It was literally like a movie. She was holding it and she dropped it. I knew. I didn't have to ask. No one said anything.
January 3rd, 2008, we were living with my mother-in-law at the time. My son was 22 months old and I was 5 months pregnant with my daughter. And that night, my phone rang and it was a fireman calling to tell me that there had been an accident and that a car was coming to pick me up. It was the longest ride of my life and I had to walk into the hospital and there was a sea of firemen. I felt like as I walked through, everybody's heads just went down. And I knew in that moment, but I was still holding on to hope that they would tell me it was just an accident and it was gonna be okay. I was greeted at the time by Mayor Bloomberg, who told me that John had passed in a fire. From that moment on, just everything changed.
As events happen, folks come forward and out of goodwill want to help. As time goes on, life goes on, and things move ahead. Answer the Call has never forgotten.
This is our choice. This is our free will. Family members, not so much. But they also understand the importance of the job. It takes a lot of strength and courage to be a family member of a first responder.
Answer the Call is part of my life. They know your grief, and they were a huge comfort because you can pick up the phone, and they're there for you. You know, that's really what it is for me, that Answer the Call is there. They never forget. And when you look around the room at the gala, at all those people, you feel like your husband didn't die in vain.
I remember Answer the Call first reaching out to my family very early on. The fact that they showed up right away, I felt like, okay, you know, I'm going to be okay. He's going to be remembered. It was a very, very calming feeling at a time where everything felt chaotic. My children did not get to know their father, so this is a way for them to feel connected to him, to hear how special and how significant their dad's actions were.
When we have a tragedy, Answer the Call is always there first. They are immediately on the phone asking what they can do, and they sustain that role for the last 34 years and never forget the support that they give to the first responders and police fire community.
My favorite thing about Answer the Call is that they are always there and smiling, that they care about me. They invite me to do things I would never have otherwise been able to do. For me personally, for the past 2 years, I've been singing the national anthem at the annual gala. Yeah, it honestly changed my life. It could have been a lot worse.
Answer the Call has helped my family in many ways. I've attended the family game a few times. 1 year, my son actually got to throw out the first pitch at one of the games. It gave him an opportunity that he normally wouldn't have. It was a moment that he'll never forget. I'm very, very grateful that they always remember not only John, but they remember the people that he left behind. They remember his children. And it's a way for his children to see really just how important he was.
To the supporters of Answer the Call, thank you. Thank you for your generosity.
Well, thank you all for answering the call, for supporting this organization, and for supporting those who've given it all for the sake of others. Thank you for supporting their families.
Thank you for answering the call.
Thank you for answering the call.
Thank you for answering the call.